What you're looking at is the starter code for the Sudoku solver project that we're going to work on in this lesson. This code can be found not only in your course materials, but also in the description field of the YouTube page for this video. The code that is shown here is complete with the exception of one method, and that's the method that you have to write, which is the solve method. Normally, backtracking uses recursion, but in this particular problem, we have constructed the code in such a way that the backtracking can be done using a simple while loop shown here. While the body of the while loop is your responsibility, we have provided you with the pseudocode to help you figure out exactly what you need to do inside this while loop. Let's examine some of the methods in this code that you'll be using inside this while loop. Here we've defined two hash maps to allow us to translate between groups shown by the various colored blocks here and the individual cell numbers. So for example, here in this first hash map, given an index, we can return the group number. So for example, if given the index 11, the hash map would return 0 because cell 11 belongs to group 0. The groups here are numbered from 0 to 8. The second hash map goes in the other direction. Given a group number, it returns an array of integers that describe all the cells that belong to that group. So for example, if you give it the number 1, it would return all the numbers in this pink group here, 3, 4, 5, 12, 13, 14, 21, 22, and 23. This is the constructor for the Sudoku solver, which simply initializes all the member variables. These methods here are fairly self-explanatory. Here, given a cell index, it can tell you what row it's in. This one can tell you what column it's in. Here, given a cell index and given a current position, this method returns true if there's a conflict in the row that the cell index belongs to. In other words, if the number is repeated somewhere in the row. Here is the calculation done to figure out if there's a column conflict, and here's a slightly harder calculation done to figure out if there's a conflict in one of the groups shown here. This valid position method determines whether the current position being examined is a valid Sudoku position or not. The way the program works is that at any given time, we have a current board position. In the current board position, we have all the numbers that were given in the starting position, and we're pointing to an individual cell. We attempt to load the current cell with different values and check to see if that particular value creates a conflict on the board. If it does, we try a different value. If we've run through all the different values possible, then we have what's known as an overflow, in which case we have to do backtracking. This backtracking was described in the last video. A valid position on this board consists of no conflicts in any row, column, or group number, and the cell pointer currently pointing to a value that's greater than 0 and less than 10. Now let's take a look at the Sudoku solver in action. If we start off by giving it some values as a starting position on the board, then we compile and run it, we see that the Sudoku solver prints the starting position at the top and then finishes by showing us the solved position for the final board. It is your job to fill in the while loop of the solve method to get this program to work as intended.